Hi guys, this is Eric, and I'm gonna show you my Denali X Wind. I got this for 4 months now, and I'm actually doing this video because I'm gonna have a vacuum inside of it. We went to Browns Beach in York Peninsula, that's here in South Australia. We camped there for 2 nights, 3 days. And we went fishing. That's where I got my catch and cook video. So I'm just gonna show you my Denali X Wind tent. This is a two-person tent, and I always separate my poles from the actual fly and the inside tent, so that I could put this inside my bag and this outside. So let's pitch it. And this is a freestanding tent, so you could move it anywhere. I'm just disappointed with the pegs, because it was so windy and we're basically in the sand. Oops. This is how big it is. Really small. Really bad. Bad size. And so with the poles, you won't get confused with it, because you got the silver one that goes across from left to right, and you got the orange ones that goes across back to front. One thing I noticed about this tent was it had a wet patch in the middle on top, but aside from that, everything was dry. With the brand. It's with a different color. You got different you got the hole on one of the clips here where you could put your pegs, but this one, with the green one, you have to insert it at the end of the pole, because there's a hole in the pole, as you can see. You can see that. And because of that, I got holes on my, I got a hole on my pet, because that metal bit there was actually, rubbing against the bottom sheet of the tent, so it had a hole, and I couldn't find the repair kit. So I had different color of material in there. As you can see, you insert it there and it locks on. I think it's good because it's way in, but the thing is, it pokes a hole in the tent. So that's a no-no. There you go. I think this would be really good during the summer because of the netting. And the this rip stop material is really high, so it's you will really get you won't really get wet. Because I think it's about a foot high, and it means that no water is coming in. But if you have a hole, then that's a problem. So you could see that there's a red dot here, that's the hole caused by this design of poking it in the actual hole. So you get this carabiner here that actually holds both the poles. Secures them together because there are two guy lines located this side here in the fly, and that's one of my concern as well, because there's only two guy lines. Would have been nice if there was another guy line at the back, because during that night it was really windy. Then just clip it in, tighten. See, with this design here, I'll show it to you closer in a while. Just stops up all the clipping points because it's not straight. Explain why it was a bit cheaper than the red one. The red one is a different design. So that's it. So I'll walk you through. So this is the side of it, and on both sides there's only two of these guy lines, and it's not really enough to hold it. And this is what I was talking about. See, because of this ring here, it doesn't really clip up straight. It's on an angle. So that's, I think that's a flaw there, but I think this is really good, but it would puncture the material. And it has its ventilation there, so pretty good space. I mean, size for the ventilation, and then you could just Velcro it shut. I didn't have precipitation inside, I mean condensation, whatever it is, but I noticed that in here that middle bit had a wet spot, but that was just about it. So we'll go inside. So it got Velcros
zipper. So this is sort of your vestibule, but it's not really big. Sort of small. And cons with this is that, look at that. If it was raining, you'd be wet inside. Because this, there's no roof. But inside is really spacious. Well, everything is spacious because I'm really small. I'm 5'5", so everything's big to me. Okay. You have your clip for your light. Then here we go. You got your side pockets there. And another one on the other side. And yeah, I'll show you a better view when I'm inside. Okay, I'll get in. And yeah, so I'm 5'5". At the end of it, close to the door, I could sit down properly, barely touching my head. It's spacious. Definitely a two-person with my size. But if you have your gears, I think it's not the way to go because it's a bit small. Yeah. I'll get my bag and show you. So this is my 55 liter bag. So if it was in here, and then there's two of us, you can't really use the vestibule. This is big. So this will stand here, or lie down like that. Then I'll have my pad, sleeping bag, barely room for two, if plastic gears. So definitely, a one person thing. I'll show you the inside. The battery's a bit low, so I'm gonna use my lamp to light up inside. Okay. So here it is. So not really a two-person tent when the bag is here. Plus you, basically just you. That's about it. I lie down and it's full of sand. See you later. Hope this helps.